Let's say the price of a condo is $180,000. So that's the amount that the seller will get. Part of that money will come directly from your pocket, and part of it will come as a loan from the bank that they'll give you in order to complete the sale. So the bank requires that you put down 5% of the cost of the condo, and they'll pay the other 95%. There's also this one point at closing, and we'll deal with that in a second. Let's say you plan to finance this condo with a 30-year mortgage at 4% interest. So our ultimate goal is to find the monthly payment amount for this mortgage. The first thing we need to do is calculate how much the loan amount will actually be. Because remember, you're paying 5% today, and the loan amount is the remaining 95%. So the down payment is 5% of $180,000. Which is 180,000 times 0.05, or $9,000. So, if you're putting $9,000 down, the remainder of the cost of the condo, everything except for that $9,000 you pay today, is financed by this loan. So that would be $171,000. So you're taking out a $171,000 loan, and you're also paying $9,000 that you have saved up now. And those two together cover the entire cost of the condo. So, summarizing what we have so far, we need to put down $9,000 today and take out a loan of $171,000. Then these closing costs don't come into the terms of the loan, but we'll calculate them anyway. Closing costs are an administrative fee that the bank charges at the time of the loan. And that one point at closing means that it's 1%, so each point is one percentage point, 1% of not the cost of the condo, but of the loan amount, because the loan is really all that the bank sees. And so one point at closing is 1% of the loan amount. So 1% of 171,000 is $1,710. So that's just a fee that you pay during the process of taking out this loan. But it doesn't reduce the loan amount at all. That doesn't go toward the loan, it's just a fee you have to pay. So to calculate the monthly payment amount, we use the installment loan formula. Here we're given P, the amount of the loan, that's the $171,000. We're given R, the interest rate is 4%. We're given N, because this is a monthly payment, so N is 12, and T is 30 years, because it's a 30-year mortgage. So we simply fill in all those pieces, and now we need to calculate what this expression equals. So again, I'll start in the denominator with the innermost parentheses. Type in 1 plus 0.04 divided by 12. Raise that answer to the negative 12 times 30. Take 1 minus that answer, and this now is the entire denominator. So I'm going to store that number to come back to later. And now I'll calculate the numerator. So I take 171,000 times 0.04 divided by 12, and then divide this answer by the stored denominator. So my monthly payment amount is $816.38. Now let's ask one more question. Once we know the payment amount, how much are we actually paying in interest on this loan? And this calculation we've done before, at least in part. If I'm paying $816.38, and I'm doing this for 30 years, 12 times a year, that means I make 360 payments, 30 times 12. So 360 payments of this amount, plus the down payment that I pay today, tells me how much money I actually pay for this condo. So if we calculate that, multiply this by 360 and add 9,000. For the condo, I pay a total of $302,896 and some change. Now, if the price of the condo was $180,000, the difference between the $180,000 and what I've actually paid is all the interest that I paid. So if I subtract off the cost of the condo, I find that over the life of this loan, I pay nearly $123,000 in interest. That's a significant amount, and that's consistent with mortgages in general. The loans are long enough that the interest payments add up to a pretty significant amount. So the question just asks to find the monthly payment for the mortgage, but once we do that, we can do other calculations like this one to evaluate whether this loan is a good idea or not.